Yeah, Floppeh versus, please pronounce it for me one more time.
We're just gonna call you N. N.
Okay, all right. So we're going with N. You know, trying to take the Death Note away and try to get the W right now. Put Floppeh's name in the book away from Light. Where are we getting right here? Battlefield game number one.
That's right. And of course, with the battle of the zoners, no surprise that we're gonna see both players actually, you know, starting with a little bit more space in between each other than we have traditionally in this tournament.
You know what? This matchup is actually pretty interesting, right? It's like he who shall ledge trap versus she who shall never be ledge trapped. This is a match where Arcfire is actually incredible against Header, but the thing is, it's still gonna go in the lead to N because N finds Floppeh getting a little bit too far downstage and not recovering.
Yeah, I think that may have been like a misinput air dodge, which really put Floppeh just people far below the stage, not gonna be able to recover that low without the ability to use your second jump.
Yeah, that's unfortunate for sure. You never want to have that type of thing go into a lead, especially with the KO power and the consistent damage that Robin can put on. But we've also seen it. Oh, looks for the air dodge read with the downer. Actually is just tearing apart all of N's landing options right now over and over again.
That's true. Okay, get some deep breathing. And wow, it's like N is having some difficulty coming back to the stage with Floppeh only taking really 2% this entire stock after making like a huge mistake on its first.
Yeah, that really tells the tale. Like, if that SD didn't happen, we might be looking at a pretty significant lead for Floppeh. But, like, N has just not been able to find that opening again. Like, they were boxing quite a bit at the start, but N hasn't been able to set up a single, like, zoning attempt, any arc fires at the ledge, because all these sun salutations are just stopping him. And anytime he tries to go for a shot, he just gets beat out.
That's true. And as you can see, like, Floppeh sitting really comfortable at the ledge, you know, even rolling on the stage, but here we go. N getting a little bit of damage onto Floppeh. Down throw, and both players, what are you doing? That's usually not where two combatants will spend majority of their time off stage, underneath the stage.
These two are hungry for that spike. Like, they have spent so much time off stage where both of them, like I said before, N is so great at ledge, but he hasn't been able to really find that ledge trap yet. And meanwhile, Floppeh is like, oh, I'm gonna go down there. I know you have no hitbox on your recovery other than beneath it, so I got like three spikes. I'm gonna find one of them.
That's true. There's the back air out of shield and sitting pretty in shield, but using the ball to his advantage, extending the hitbox on the Levin sword, and Floppeh getting caught. That's N adjusting and utilizing his tools.
I feel like that's gotta be cheating against the rules, right? Like, I don't think anybody's allowed to bring electric swords onto the court like that, so I'm gonna need,
yeah, I don't know.
I'm gonna need somebody to call the ref real quick.
Look at it! There's a couple characters with guns.
Yeah, you're right, Kirby's got a gun. Oh, you gotta be careful at the ledge like that too, because if you go for Header, you put your head above the ledge like that, down smash is super strong. It sends at a really good angle.
Oh, he's gonna go for a spike. Not again. They traded, and I think Floppeh may have been expecting a tech situation. That's why we saw the buffered air dodge.
Uh-huh.
That's so unfortunate for it to happen once, but we saw it happen twice.
Yeah, that's that pain. But you know what? Even though it did happen twice, it's not something you ever want to happen whatsoever. But Floppeh still looked really good in that game. And going in, if the mindset is still good, it's like, hey, look, that I SD'd twice and still played very well, was understanding a lot of stuff, but I was still really, I was winning a majority of the time on most situations, right, especially covering landings. You go into game two with a clear head and just like, you know what? Forget game one, I'm gonna run it right back.
Or not. Maybe we see Floppeh switching something up. I'm gonna guess that it's gonna be a stage select, because I really don't. Floppeh's really not known for playing any other characters outside of Wii Fit. I know he was messing with some other characters at the beginning of Smash Ultimate, but you know, whenever you're try and true calls, that's really who you gotta stick with your big guns. And
yeah,
for Floppeh, it's Wii Fit.
I would be hard pressed and very surprised to see anything that doesn't have a platform attached to it, because although Robin is a bit of a zoner, it's still significantly more in favor for Robin to have platforms to get pressure on platforms, 11 swords, be able to call jumps out, and like just not have to deal with full screen zoning. So if we actually went to something like FD, see PS2, that makes a solid amount of sense, because you still have plenty of platform work to work with.
Yeah, that's very true. Still flat stage, still able to utilize some platforms to your advantage, but whoa, Thoron!
All right, I mean, what's a full screen? Just throw out my strongest spell, just put it all on you. And looking for command grab early on too, to try and catch Floppeh early. I like the fact that we're seeing more utilization out of the spells here in this game, because N was really more about boxing in the last one. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like making Floppeh actually respect him at mid-screen now.
Yeah, as you can see, like, N is not afraid to swing at that ball. It worked out for him in the first game, and now here in the second game, he's going to continue to hit the ball with the Levin Sword because it's going to extend the hitbox in case Floppeh tries to follow up.
I will say this. Floppeh is currently living rent-free in N's head on every air dodge. I don't think I've seen a single air dodge that has not gone unpunished or gets, like, a tremendous amount of pressure after. N has to be careful with these landings because Floppeh has been tearing him up.
Yeah. This stage is, like, it's definitely working in Floppeh's favor, at least at the start. We'll see what happens a little bit later on. But more ball action just continues. These headers are just snipes. Oh, yeah, see, and another air dodge, you're right.
Every single one of them has been covered in the correct method, and it's just, and right there, not going to get anything out of it, but like forcing them to go low. Is he going to read something off the jump? I like the fact that Floppeh tried to respect the get up there. Throw shouldn't take it out just yet, but a little bit longer will.
Yeah, forcing the air dodge once again. Oh, he didn't release it. He didn't shoot the sun. Running right through and in, making the big play, going off stage with the down air.
If anybody in this room is surprised by that down air, you weren't paying attention to game one. Both of these players are just hunting for that down air over and over, and N finally is the one to find it. But great answer right afterwards with the sun salutation. And once again, she who shall not be ledge trapped. Five per person. What are you doing all the way down there? That's what happens when you go that deep for a down air where nobody existed. And now Floppeh is up 2-1.
Okay, you know what? I'm happy that these two are just continuing on. And you know what? They're always on the right side of the stage. I don't know what it is about these two players that favor the right side of the stage just going off and hunting each other. But apparently that's the hunting grounds. That's where you go. The safari zone, the right side of the stage.
I think Floppeh already understood. He's like, you know what? I SD'd on that last game on the left. Let's go ahead, chill on the right. You're right. They really have been favoring that over there. This is the first time we've seen them boxing on this side. What, is he going to go off stage? Of course he is. Of course he is.
What would you expect from these players other than to go off stage and try and end them? End the other person.
This is beautiful. This is beautiful. This is what we like to see. There's money on the line. There's people trying to get it, but they're trying to get the meta view clips. They're trying to make sure that they establish. Look, I know you have a pretty bad vertical recovery. Nothing that will stop it. That was great coverage right there, but did it run up and go for the up smash? That could have possibly KO'd.
That's typically the bread and butter that we see. We see the arc fire connect, and it's usually followed up by some forward airs or an up air up smash. And at these higher percents, you expect to see the up smash. But here we go. Both these players again chucking elements, chucking sports equipment at each other.
Oh my god. What a hidden boss to run into, right? You're sitting there, you get done, go through chapter 19. You're like, all right, there's an extra route over here. You walk into what looks like a dojo, and it's just Wii Fit chilling in there. Not anymore, though, because that up smash is going to take the stock.
Mm-hmm. But just dropping right off the angel right platform all and right doing a couple stretches.
All right.
And guess what, Ajax? We're going to game three.
All right.
Hit those yoga poses. I don't know about you, but I'm stretching it out. I gotta stretch it out.
I look. I want the chat to learn something real quick. When you die, right? When you come back, there's this thing called invisibility frames that you get. Now, as the other player at kill percent, for some reason, a lot of y'all really like to think, wow, shiny. And you run right at the flashing target, and you know what happens? You die. And it happens so often. You know what you should probably do? Stay in a safe position. Because if you hold shield, especially if they don't got a kill throw, you're not going to die. So maybe don't run up right at them. So that happens all the times. It happened to N. We're going into game three. That drives me nuts every time I see it.
It's the cross up at zero. Or the cross under at zero. They're trying to like mix them up by running underneath them. Like, they're not going to see that coming.
I say, look, she just came out from the beach. You want to go compliment on the tan, looking real crisp, real shiny, but you know what? She ain't about it. She wants you to go away, and that's what you get. Actually, both of them are shining bright like a diamond right now, running right at the wrong target, though, taking 26%. She doesn't want you to come anywhere near here, and it's continuing at 41% too.
Okay, but the ball getting hit by Thorn, you know, putting a little bit of numbers on Floppeh.
Down air. Yep.
I knew always. It. Every time. Love it. More down airs.
I respect it. I mean, look, I'm also a big fan of holding advantage and staying at the ledge, especially if your character is the king of the ledge, similar to that of Robin. But occasionally you want to go off stage. However, not too much. You didn't get anything out of it, and Floppeh is still looking very comfortable here at 32%.
Mm-hmm. And of course, you know, here we go. Are we gonna start seeing Floppeh like really get those air dodge traps again, like we were seeing in game two? So far, we haven't seen a punish on too many air dodges. Yeah, but at the same time, these numbers are still racking up.
See, there was no punish necessarily, but Floppeh knew that N wasn't going to swing, so he actually took the time to get deep breathing up. He still understands that the air dodges are coming. He's just leaving him alone right now to remove the conditioning that he had on N before. That way, N will think, oh, I can air dodge safely here, and he's going to get blown up.
All right, so yeah, Floppeh really just going for the reset and the mental game.
Sometimes you got to do that in game three, especially with a lead like this. If you give up all your tricks too quick, it's going to be easy for N to make the run back, because we've already seen N has lived to high percents quite a bit, but usually ends up taking the stock first.
Yeah, I mean, let's think about game two. We saw a very similar numbers even at the first stocks, where it looked like N was having difficulty really getting in and putting numbers on Floppeh. But what happened? Floppeh got off stage, down air came out, connected, and suddenly Enarmonia was in, you know, it was sitting pretty.
Yeah, I was so close to popping off that header to spike worked a second ago. The one, like the freaking hidden missile, Dr. Doom coming through with the last second assist. But Floppeh is just, even though Floppeh can't find a KO Floppeh right now, I don't know. I remember there was a campaign at some point where WeFits were trying to convince us that Uppy out of shield was a good option. Uppy in center stage, not so much. I don't think you're going to convince me on that one.
Yeah, I don't know. I got to see the evidence to really be
swayed
on that.
I
got to
see the receipts.
Yeah. we need to do a couple audits before that happens. But there we go. Catching the roll, F tilt is the choice from Floppeh.
I like it. Keep it simple. Keep it safe. You know what? Oh my God! And then get betrayed by your own header once again. Get the ref on the court, please. We got swords and spells. This is not how the game is supposed to be played.
So much illegal activity. If this was any other sports game, you know, I would have been calling the ref. Give him the red card. Get him out of here.
What kind of foul do you even call that? Is it a technical foul because he's a tactician, or
a
is it just
foul,
a man? That's a deep personal foul. Oh, that's big damage right there. Yep, get that health back. Good job. I like it. Rather than going for stage positioning, you take the percent lead back. And now look at N. After that pressure Floppeh had at the start, N is just taking it back.
Yeah, even trading projectiles, you know, honestly, if I'm N, I'm going to take a header for an arc fire any day of the week.
Oh, you're so lucky that header came through and stopped that Thorn. I thought that N was going to save it. That's the second time in a row now you've been caught on the roll by the back air, which means N is definitely looking for something else this time. Oh. And there it is. Calls out the jump, but no KO.
Yeah, and you know, we really haven't been seeing N use the lower versions of the lightning spell. So for him to not only throw out Thoron where Floppeh was in no position to really get hit, and then utilize like the level 1 or level 2 of Thunder, that was crazy. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think he kind of understood, like, you know what, my early charges really aren't working too well. That time, recognizing I know you're going to go for a header, and it gets smacked back away. But still, like, he's starting to change it up a lot. And I like N's adjustments that he's been making. Not that I'm fearing Floppeh's chances.
He
got hit by that, though.
Yeah, that would have been the game. That would have been the set. But Floppeh, you know, struggling to make it back. It's taking the same. Oh, no, are we going to see the back air? Right. The back air connects. And N!
Beautifully,
and it
beautifully played by N, especially because of this exact reason. Floppeh, you rolled a lot. You got hit a lot for it.